if you tuned in late, we are talking about Gateway House, which is kind of unique, and it's located here in Greenville, South Carolina. But there are other places all across the country where there is help and outreach to people who are struggling with some form of mental illness. And it's all degrees. I mean, some of it can be dramatic and drastic, and some will be not even noticeable.
That's right. And you know, at Gateway House, you know, the things that we do every day are being done all over the world in a very similar way. Gateway House is modeled after Fountain House in New York City. Fountain House is the oldest program like Gateway House
in the country. Now, that's where you went to study.
Where I went for training in 1977. Mm-hmm. But Fountain House was actually started by former mental patients from Rockland State Hospital.
Okay.
And they met on the library steps and would support each other and help each other find a job or a place to live. And then later on, some volunteers got involved, and Fountain House was birthed. And John Beard was the first director of Fountain House. And Fountain House is the oldest program in existence. So this isn't a new model. It isn't a new way of working.
All right.
It's been around for many years.
But you help people become, they can hold jobs. They can be part of society that...
Of course, going to work, having a job is something that most of our members want.
Yeah.
And, you know, we have a variety of job placements in the community. We have jobs at Furman University, North Greenville University, Bob Jones, MetLife, TJ Maxx, Signature, just a variety of placements. And staff from Gateway House will go in and learn the job, and then we'll train a member to work on that position. If it's a full-time job, we divide it into two part-time jobs. But staff train the members, and the members work for 6 to 9 months on each job and then move from one job to another. It's called transitional employment. And then we help members move on to competitive employment or back to school. We're really focusing a lot now on education because too often our members are diagnosed with a serious mental illness while they're in high school or early college. And so we're helping members get back into working on their education, career goals.
Okay, and Mike, you have a job?
Not right now, Peggy. I go to Gateway.
All right.
And I go from like 9:30 to 3, sometimes till 4:30. And what I love about Gateway, you know, it gives you structure and routine. And when I wake up in the morning, it's easy for me to get up because I know that my friends are at Gateway.
You have a place to go.
Yes, ma'am. It's a great place. It really gives you routine. And a lot of our members, when they're ready, after coming to the program, a lot of them feel like, well, I have the stamina built up. I'm ready to go back to work or school.
Mm-hmm. Good for you.
Thank you.
Yeah. I think one of the first things a person has to do in order to go to work is get out of bed.
Yeah.
So,
and that's hard for all of us. But, you know, our members wake up in the morning. They know they're needed at Gateway House. So it gives them a reason to get up and come in to be with their friends and you know, contribute something to the operation of Gateway House.
Okay, now where does your funding come? This is not, I know some churches donate to you, but this is not based on any church or religious foundation. This is something totally apart from that.
We get funding from a variety of sources. We are a United Way agency.
All right.
We're a partner agency. We get funding from Medicaid. The service that we provide is a Medicaid reimbursable service. About 60% of our members have Medicaid. So we are able to get a good bit of funding from that source. We also have funding in the state budget. We work very hard to maintain state funding. We get funding from local foundations, national foundations, individuals, churches. Our goal is to diversify our funding so that we're not so dependent on any one funding source.
And you really do present meaningful programs. It isn't just somebody, they come and have something to keep them occupied. I mean, this has a purpose beyond just helping them for the day.
Yes, all the work at Gateway House benefits the operation of Gateway House. When I was director of a day treatment program in Savannah, we made leather belts and ceramic ashtrays and had a variety of group activities, but that didn't help people move on with their lives. But at Gateway House, being involved in the meaningful work, contributing something meaningful, it builds up a member's confidence, They realize that they can be productive, they can work, and that makes a big difference. And then also, you know, as far as housing goes, when Gateway House first started, almost all of our members lived in residential care facilities or group homes. Mm-hmm. Now, almost all of our members live in their own apartment without a roommate. And, you know, having a roommate's not easy.
No.
So we focus on providing independent living for each person as opposed to having a roommate situation.
And these people are able then to work and make a contribution.
Absolutely. You know, isolation is one of the biggest problems associated with a serious mental illness. People tend to isolate in the community,
True. You know, I mean, if somebody has cancer, everybody understands what they're talking about.
Right.
But if somebody has a mental illness, they feel compassion, but they kind of shy away. They don't even know how to describe what it could be, mm-hmm. or there's a sense of fear there.
You know, there's a real stigma associated with mental illness. And, you know, too often...
Why do you think that is?
Well, I think too often people people with a mental illness are associated with crimes. And I think that's part of the problem. But people with a serious mental illness, like schizophrenia, they are less violent than the general population. And, you know, so I think there's a real misunderstanding, a real myth about mental illness and violence. It's just not true. There are people who are mentally ill that are violent.
Yeah.
There are people who aren't diagnosed with mental illness that are violent.
Yes. Read your local newspaper every day or turn on your newscast.
And some people are just evil. I mean, you know.
That's right.
They're not mentally ill. They're evil. So, I mean, there is a myth. And it's just not true.
Now, you tell you, this is not just for men.
Oh, no.
I mean, we have Mike here with us today, but...
It's for men and women.
And
yes.
Men and women, age 18 on.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
And you really do, you have consultants and staff and trained people.
Mm-hmm. That's right. And, you know, we have licensed master's level social workers going out and training members to work in a dish room at Furman. You know, so we have staff that are really committed and passionate about what we do. And our staff, you know, go out and get in the trenches with the members and help them with their, you know, to learn the jobs that we are training them on. And that's really important. You don't find that in any other program.
Well, Phil, suppose somebody out there, just like me, they said, well, I'd heard about Gateway House, but I didn't really know what it was all about. I'd like to maybe get involved. How do you need people to help? Or
We do need people to help. In fact, we are having our annual signature fundraising event that's coming up on August the 7th at the Poinsett Club. It will be from 7 o'clock until 11 o'clock. And we have Fletcher Bell and Ward, a band that will be performing from Nashville. That's going to be a wonderful evening. So we always need volunteers to help with these special events.
And that's you have those throughout the year to help raise funds. So you need people in that category.
Right. Now we have this one event, Beautiful Music for Beautiful Minds, only once a year.
Mm-hmm.
But throughout the year, we often need help. We don't use volunteers in the day program because it takes away the work for the members. We rely on the members to do the work as opposed to having people come in and volunteer to do it.
Well, that's a good thing.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
You don't want them just sitting around. You want to give them a purpose.
Right. And if you come to Gateway House, and I would love to invite you to come and see what we're doing, because when you go to Gateway House and you go on a tour, you see the energy, you see the enthusiasm, you see the work that everyone's doing. There's a high energy, a lot of enthusiasm. And
so
that's
you
really
welcome
important.
People to come see Gateway House.
Oh, yes. We have, I would say, 1,000 people a year just
so
come for a tour.
So it isn't just a place behind a wall.
No. People are welcome to come for a tour, absolutely.
Yeah, that's right.
And you can learn more about Gateway House by going to our website.
Yeah.
And that's www.gateway-sc.org.
We have that information, and if you didn't get it, I'll keep it here. But, Phil, this is it's something that most of us didn't even really realize was in our midst.
Right.
And how many people do you help every day?
We
do you
have
any idea?
We have a little over 100 people a day that come in to Gateway House. And that's a lot of people. And we don't have 100 people there at one time because some members are working in the morning, they come in the afternoon. Other members work in the afternoon and come in the morning. So we don't have 100 members there at the same time.
Well, do they have like lunch? Do you have food? Or?
Yes.
Absolutely. We have a lunch every day, and it's $1.50, mm-hmm. very reasonable. Mm-hmm. And we're really focusing, too, on health and wellness. We're looking at trying to serve more nutritious foods because the research is showing that people with a serious mental illness have a life expectancy that's about 30 years less than the general population. So we're really trying to focus on teaching good nutrition, exercise, and everything that's so helpful to keep us all healthy.
That's what I said. We all need that.
Absolutely.
All of us.
I do.
Good
we
for
all
you.
Need it. Absolutely.
Yes. Thank you for sharing and letting us know what Gateway House is all about. And I thank you for coming. Phil Emery is here, and also Mike
Vinnock.
That's it. Okay. God bless you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Peggy.
Keep
thank
on
you so
with
much
the work.
For having us.
And
so
I'll
much.
Keep the information here in case you need it and didn't get it. Wherever you are, we wish you joy. Bye-bye.